بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على خير المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون، أما بعد. We continue with the عقيدة الحاوية explanation. يقول أبو جعفر رحمه الله الطحاوي: وإنه خاتم الأنبياء وإمام الأتقياء وسيد المرسلين. He continues to talk about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and our عقيدة and what we believe of him صلى الله عليه وسلم. So here he says وإنه خاتم الأنبياء، يعني the seal of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وهذا دليل عند قول الله تعالى: ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين، ويقول: وما محمد إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل. خلت من قبله الرسل يعني كل الرسل جاءت من قبله، فهذا دليل على أنه آخرهم صلى الله عليه وسلم. فخاتم النبيين يعني the last prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and the last messenger. No one. Now there are people who can claim to be prophets, but none of them is truth. So it's not no prophet will come after him. It's no one will be a true prophet after him. Many people claim to be prophets and messengers, and many people claim to be God after the Prophet ﷺ. So to make a claim is not the issue. The issue is no one is telling the truth. So sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last prophet. وكما قلنا, one of his names sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he said in hadith sahih, العاقب العاقب يعني there is no one after him, no prophet after him صلى الله عليه وسلم. And whoever believes that there is a prophet after the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم from the ummah of Islam, then he is out of Islam. Whoever believes there is a prophet after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, هذا أمر ظاهر. And this is an issue in our عقيده that is so clear and so obvious, just like the sun, that there is no prophet after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم محمد. في حديث ثوبان عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: إنه سيكون في أمتي كذابون ثلاثون كلهم يزعم أنه نبي وأنا خاتم النبيين لا نبي بعدي. He صلى الله عليه وسلم foreseen or foresaw as he told us that there will be 30 liars who claim, each will claim to be a prophet. فعل سجاح أسود العنزي في اليمن and مسيلمة continued to claim to be a prophet after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did, and many more. So the bottom line is the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the seal of the prophets, and this makes it so easy, which means now how I can take this and apply it in my life. The Prophet's business or job is to receive revelation and deliver. Ashi. So if our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the last Prophet, then we know anyone who claims, anyone who gonna come say I'm Muslim and claim to be a Prophet, or anyone who's not Muslim and claim to be a Prophet, we know he's false. But more important and more to look into it, because if someone knows that this is something established in the deen of Islam, then he will not say I'm a prophet. So he might come and say it in a different way. So anyone who comes with a new sharia, even though he might not say I'm a prophet, but the fact that he's saying I am coming with a new deen, or I'm coming here to change your deen, then we have to cross him out as well. Because now he's taking on the job of a prophet. So he doesn't have to say, I'm a prophet. So anyone who comes to say, the Prophet ﷺ, yes, he told us this, and he ordered us to do this, but let's change it this way. Allah, even though he's not saying I'm a prophet, but he's acting like a prophet, we cross him out. Very important. One of the common things that circulating these days because of the technology and all that, is they tell you so-and-so important sheikh had a dream. And he dreamed, in, or he saw in his dream, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him to tell his ummah 1, 2, 3. Most probably all of you received an email like that. Those 1, 2, 3 are not part of the deen. It's not one of the things that he sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us before his death. Okay? And we understand that the message is complete. So the fact that the Prophet ﷺ will come to someone in the dream and tell him, tell my ummah, 1, 2, 3, that those 1, 2, 3 were not told in the first place before his death, as if he ﷺ forgot and he came in the dream to remind this person or to tell this person what he forgot. So these emails and these circulations, we reject. Ashi? Very important. And if usually in these emails, at the end, and if you don't send this to 37 people, then you're going to lose a finger or a pinky or whatever those, And if you don't say it a million times, a 300 times, whatever it is, all these things, dajjal, and all these things intended, and I have no doubt whatsoever that these are fabricated and created by the enemies of Islam. No doubt. And obviously there are enough people in the Muslim world who are so naive, who will fall for these things. But an entertaining website attacking Islam. This website will never go in the world and become well known if it was to stay on its own. So what's this owner or the creator of this website gonna do? He gonna go and write an email to a Muslim list. And he goes, for example, Islamic Find, and take him emails, and emails of the Muslim businesses, Muslim individuals all over. He make a list. As I'm on one of the lists, most probably a lot of you received the same from something Alan, who's like a priest or something, and he sends to tell us that why Jesus is this, and they keep sending him back smiles. Smiley faces. What is that? Anyway, so he'll come, this person who created or founded this website against Islam. And he picked 10, 20, 30, 100 emails of Muslims. And he sends an email of this address of his website, warning. Ashi? Or this message, he's acting as a Muslim. This message, we need to spread this email or this website to warn Muslims of this website. So what happens? Every Muslim starts forwarding this email to his group, to his list. And suddenly the website, a Muslim is curious. Who aslan his target is to Muslims. Who he wants to put doubt in the hearts of the Muslims. So now every single Muslim in town knows about this website. And curiosity is a killer. Curiosity kills. The Muslim, Allah, I know my deen, let me see what they say, let me laugh a little. And then he starts the shubuhat, start playing in his head and in his heart. And he starts following. So hadari. And I warn of this all the time. Even people at very high level of ilm and intellect fall for these things. Emails that come warning of specific websites. Don't do that. Don't forward them. Delete. Because now once you forward, you're helping spreading the word. That is how they do it. So let's be careful and be intelligent and wise. Okay? So again, the Prophet ﷺ, the last Prophet, but many people came after him, brought a new deen to Islam. That's why he warned ﷺ, he said, مَنْ أَحْدَثَ فِي أَمْرِنَا هَذَا مَلَيْسَ مِنْهُ فَهُوَ رَدٍّ وَمَنْ قَالَ عَلَيَّ مَا لَمْ أَقُلْ فَلْيَتَبَوَّ مَقَعْدَهُ مِنَ النَّارِ مَنْ كَذَبَ عَلَيَّ مُتَعَمِّدًا فَلْيَتَبَوَّ مَقَعْدَهُ. Many hadith, هذا حديث متواتر أيضا. Many صحابة narrate this hadith. He who lies about me intentionally, let him assume his spawn in the hell fire. Ada, to bring a new deen. To bring new stuff into the deen. The one, the only one who's allowed to bring new stuff in the deen, by the order of Allah, is Prophet. So anyone who comes to act that way, even though he doesn't say I'm a prophet, he's doing the job of a prophet in this aspect, and such person is rejected, should be rejected. And also, since he's the last prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you must believe that he was sent to all people. Because if he's the last messenger, and there is no messenger after him, then that means he's sent to all people. Because every prophet before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent to his own people. Min Nuh alayhi salam to Isa alayhi salam. Everyone was sent to his people. So when there is one that Allah tells us, this is the last one, it must mean to everyone now. Because if it's only specific people, what's about the rest? If he's telling us, this is the message, this is the last prophet. If it's to the last or to this group of people, let's say to the Arabs. If Muhammad was sent sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the Arabs, because the prophet usually sent to his own people. طيب, are there new people going to be or new nations going to be established? Of course, all the time. طيب, those people, if Muhammad was the last one, who's their prophet? So believing or part of believing that the Prophet ﷺ is the final messenger, part of that is that he was sent to all mankind, because that what makes sense. Since he's the last one, khalas, the last chance. And this chance is going to be for everyone. Okay? يقول الله تعالى قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا. Allah Azza wa Jal tells the Prophet ﷺ, tell the people, all people, I am the messenger of Allah to all of you. All of you. No exception. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَّةً لِلنَّاسِ. يقول الله تبارك الذي نزل الفرقان على عبده ليكون للعالمين نذيرا للعالمين للعالمين يعني to all mankind. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ للعالمين. Not to the Arabs, not to the Middle Easterns, not to those, not to that. To العالمين. All mankind. So whoever believes, pay attention, what? The consequence of believing. النتائج الإيمان أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أرسل للناس كافة. فمن اعتقد أن أحدا يسعه الخروج عن شرع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. أي أحد. من اعتقد أن أحدا يسعه الخروج عن الشرع أو شرع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فهو كافر. إيش يعني؟ يعني once we establish that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was sent to all people, so if a Muslim comes and think for a second that a Christian or Jew or a Hindu or Buddhist can be saved through his conviction, through his religion, without reverting to the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then this person is kafir, the Muslim. And how many we hear all the time? Good Christian, good Jew, good this. Well, I have a friend who's Christian, he's very nice, and he's better than someone. Alec. Dangerous, dangerous, dangerous. Some people come and say, well, I have Christian friends better than many Muslims I meet. Most probably, you have a personal issues with those Muslims, that's why you measure those Christians better than them. So again, it has to do with your person. Maybe you used to ask them for money, they didn't lend you, the Christian did. Suddenly the Christian is better. For your personal issue. And what's your criteria when you said, wallah, some Christians better than Muslims? Mahada, it's so dangerous, can take you to kufr. That's how dangerous it is. That's how dangerous it is. Who was this Christian who says God is three? What could the Muslim do to make him worse? Seriously. What, the Muslim commit zina? Drink alcohol? Take drugs? Bad manners? Inta as Muslim. Are all these things comparable to shirk? Isn't shirk the biggest sin? So what a Muslim could do, that by any means and any measure could make them better or worse than Mushrik, Nasrani, Yahudi, Budi, Hindusi. Nafi. But most probably you did not even come across these things. Most probably your evaluation had nothing to do with any of those. Most probably your evaluation had to do with your evaluation had to do with personal issues. Personal issues. Fahadad. So the bottom line is, after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the person who hears of his message and continue not to believe in it, in our aqeedah and in our faith and our belief, is kafir, will go to hellfire for it. Had he received the message the right way. Imagine, had he received the message the right way. Very important. Anyone who receives the message of Islam and rejects it, receives it in the right fashion and rejects it, then this person indeed, if he dies on that, خالد مخلد في الجهة في النار forever will be lasting forever in the hellfire. Very important. Imagine. So you see, it's not only about, so far we talked about that the Prophet ﷺ, the last Prophet. Look how many things we came out of that. How many things came out of that in our life. When we said, someone doesn't have to claim to be a prophet for us to know that he's lying. Whoever comes trying to change our Sharia and our deen, we say no. We say Muhammad ﷺ done. Okay, someone these emails and these, someone dreamed that the Prophet ﷺ told him to tell his ummah that. Cross. If the message that the Prophet told him to tell his ummah, 1, 2, 3 things that the Prophet already ordered us, then we say sure. Amma to come completely with the new stuff. And the Prophet tells you, tell your ummah that the Prophet wants them to pray 2 rak'ah on such and such day coming, or the end of this month for this. The new deen. This is a new deen we reject. And then the third thing, the Prophet ﷺ is messenger. The fact that he's the last messenger, that means he's to everyone. So the only way that someone can be saved is by following Muhammad ﷺ. I don't hesitate to say that, regardless of what they would think of you. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والذي نفس محمد بيده لا يسمع بي أحد من هذه الأمة يهودية ولا نصرانية ثم يموت ولم يؤمن بالذي أرسلت به إلا كان من أصحاب النار. والذي نفسي بيده. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم swears by Allah. والذي نفس محمد بيده. By the one who controls the soul of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. No Jew or Christian hears of me and does not believe in me, but will be in the hellfire. Very clear. So you want to play with it? What you want to come out with? Very clear. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم لو كان موسى حيا ما وسعه إلا اتباع. Even if Musa, he صلى الله عليه وسلم, see عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه reading in pieces of the Torah. The Jews wrote it for him. So he صلى الله عليه وسلم get angry and he said, if Musa was to be alive today, he will have no choice but to follow me. Why are you reading it? My message came to abrogate all these things. This is a clear message to the Muslims, who still the basics of his deen doesn't know, and he wants to debate the Christians and the Jews, and he goes reading the Bible and that. Know your deen, then you go that path. But master your deen. But then you don't know your deen, so you're gonna go and read in their books. What? How are you gonna know what's right and what's wrong? And how are you gonna go? How are you gonna know what to debate them with and what? If you don't know your deen, you might go and debate them with something that is in your deen, but you misunderstood it from their books. So you go, you debate them this and this, and then they show you, it's in your deen too. Nashi, very careful. We say you should not read in the Bible or in the Torah. Period. However, if you want to take it on yourself to defend Islam and to show these non or these Christians and Jews that their books are wrong, We say you have no choice before you go into their books to master your book and your books. To know your deen, know the Quran, know the Sunnah of the Prophet, know your basics. Any question I can ask you in your deen and you don't know in the fundamentals. I'm not talking about furu', I'm talking about fundamentals. And you don't know, and then you want to read in the books of the Jews and Christians. This is suicide. And Isa alayhi salam, when he comes, he gonna rule with the deen of Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He gonna rule with the Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he gonna pray behind the Imam of the Muslimin. And this is the honor to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قال المؤلف رحمه الله وإمام الأتقياء إمامهم يعني مقدمهم أو مقدمهم. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Ja'far al-Tahawi said, خاتم الأنبياء وإمام الأتقياء. Imam al-Atqiya, يعني the leader of those who have taqwa. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أتقى الناس وأتقى الجن. بين الإنس والجن هو أتقى صلى الله عليه وسلم. هي صلى الله عليه وسلم أتقى الخلق. أتقى الخلق. And the reason I mention the jinn, because his message was sent to the jinn as well. His message was to the ins and the jinn. سواء. فهو صلى الله عليه وسلم أتقى أمتي بل أتقى خلق الله عز وجل. وهذا التقوى بشكل عام. أما أنت يجوز أن تسأل to be the leader of متقين certain types of متقين. وهذا قول الله تعالى about عباد الرحمن والذين يقولون ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. هذا specific type of متقين. أما أنت لا يجوز أن تقول to mean that to make you the leader of all متقين. فذاك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. فهو صلى الله عليه وسلم إمام المتقين يعني أو في الآية when you make that دعاء أنت you ask Allah to make you a role model for the good people. To make you an example for the good people. In other words, for Allah to make you an example for the good people, that means you're asking Him to make you good, to make you a good person, because that's the only way you can be example. قال أبو جعفر رضي رحمه الله وسيد المرسلين. سيد المرسلين يعني أفضلهم. The Prophet ﷺ is the best of the messengers. وهذا ما نؤمن به وندين الله به that the Prophet ﷺ the best messenger, better than Ibrahim, better than Nuh, better than Musa, better than Isa. Better than all the prophets and the messenger. صلى الله عليه وسلم. بل هو أفضل ذرية آدم. كما قال في الحديث الصحيح أنا سيد ولدي آدم ولا فخر. He صلى الله عليه وسلم the best of all the children of Adam. The best. Not only the messengers. All of them. And anyway, ومن باب تحصيل حاصل. If he is the best of the best, that means he's the best of all. If the messengers are the best of the people. Allah Azza wa Jalla will not choose someone from the people to be the messenger and there's someone better than him in the same time in his own. So the messengers are the best of the people or the best of their people. So if the Prophet is the best of the messengers, that means automatically he's the best of their people. Okay? But the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam قال عن نفسه, he said about himself, أنا سيد ولدي آدم ولا فخر. I am the best of the son of Adam. The best. صلى الله عليه وسلم. بل أنت انظر يوم القيامة, the day of judgment, people standing there 1,000 years waiting for the reckoning, just for الحساب تصفر. مسلم كافر نافق, all of them. And the sun is so close and people tired and hungry and thirsty. هم they are so tired, they want so stressed. Forget about all that, the depression, the stress they're in. They don't know what's going to happen. عفاتٌ عُرَاتٌ غُرُلًا. Everyone is naked. عُرَاتٌ uncircumcised, just the way they were born. غُرُلًا. They wait. Then comes the first shafa'ah. Our people think that shafa'ah or the intercession of the Prophet ﷺ is to take Muslims or believers from hellfire to heaven. That's not the only one. But the first shafa'ah is for him to intercede for Allah to start the reckoning. حساب. So they go to Nuh, they go to Adam, they go to Nuh, they go to Ibrahim, they go to Musa, they go to Isa, asking them, ask Allah to start the hisab. All these prophets and great people worried about themselves. Nafsi, nafsi. Nafsi, nafsi. Everyone is worried about himself. How was that day? يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون. يوم يفر المرء من أخيه وأمي وأبيه وصاحبته وبنيه. You're running away from everyone. I worry about you right now. خلاص. هي جنة أو نار. Paradise or hellfire. There's no break. There's no come back. There's no change my mind. There's no third choice. Everyone is busy. Last chance. So they come to him. وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين. محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. الصادق الأمين. الرحيم. الذي ما عظمنا حق عظمته. صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah, we did not give him his basic rights. His basic rights. We're so arrogant when it comes to his orders as if it's coming from anyone. And he said that, okay, I don't feel like it. Man it. Adam Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. The order comes to you from a policeman, from the court, court order. You start shaking and shivering. Cop stops you on the road. Start shaking. Adam Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Sayyid Walad Adam. The best man ever created. And his order comes to you and you act like, huh? Whatever. And then we say we love him. And then we say we follow him. And then we say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. This is not the way you translate Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. When the order comes, who said it? Muhammad, khalas. This is al-aqeedah. When you hear Sayyid Walad Adam, when you hear, he's the best of prophets. You know what that means? Imam al-Atqiya, Sayyid al-Mursaleen, the leader of all those who have taqwa and the best of all the messengers. You know what that means? That means if he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was or was to order all these messengers, one thing they would have no choice but to obey. But to obey. Not us, the messengers. Musa, Isa, Ibrahim, Nuh, Lut, all of these, Hud, Salih, Shu'ayb, Zakariya, Yahya, all these. If he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants to tell them, do, they would have no choice but to do. And then you come, I come to him. To say, wallah, I'm not convinced. Wallah, I'm not ready. وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ مَنْ يَعْصِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ عصيان. Not obeying Allah or not obeying the messenger. عصيان لله والرسول. مَنْ يَعْصِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا مُبِينًا. It's not the right, and no believing man or believing woman is entitled to disobey when the order comes from Allah or from the messenger. Then you want to think. You want to consider. Well, I'm not ready. Well, my wife will not be okay with that. Well, my husband will not be okay with that. Taqillah. Where is shahada? Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Where is that translated? Now, these words need to be translated into action. هذا القول يقتضي العمل. Once you know, it necessitates that you act. Cannot just know and stay, Well, good, cool, I know more now. هذا ضدك حجة عليك. This, if it's not translated into action, will be an argument for you or against you. Will be an argument against you if what you learn does not translate into action. To what you just know and know and know. What's better for you not to know? If you're not planning to practice and not knowing, you will have no excuse with it. You come, Allah, and I didn't know. Why you didn't know? Allah, I just didn't want to add more arguments. It doesn't work like that. So there's no escape. The only choice you got is to learn and practice. Amma not learning, where you have the ability to learn, or learning and not practicing, no option against you. So be aware. So they will go to the Prophet ﷺ. After every Prophet say, nafsi, nafsi, and I did this, and I did that, they come to Muhammad ﷺ and say, Ana lah. Did you learn that from Muhammad ﷺ? That in dunya things, that you say, Ana lah? Muslims in need, Ana lah. I can do it. I can help them out. Or you run. Or you stick your head amongst the heads, huh? Like an ostrich, and wait for someone to say, Ana laha. Allah, ya ikhwan, in every word from the Messenger of Allah, there's a lesson. Bal in every harf, every letter, there's a message. Ana laha. In kana Muhammad laha yawm al-qiyamah, wa antam natba' Muhammad, fa kun laha fi dunya. If he's for it and he will take care of it on the day of judgment and you're one of his followers, then take care of it when you're in the dunya. أَنَا لَهَا فَأَسْتَأْذِنُ عَلَىٰ رَبِّي فَيُؤْذَنُ لِي. So I asked to meet Allah. So I've been given the permission. صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَيُلْهِمُنِي مَحَامِدْ أَحْمَدُهُ بِهَا. And he goes to meet Allah. Allah will inspire him to praise Allah in a way he didn't know before. So he praises him a way that he did not learn. But Allah inspired him. وَأَخِرُّ سَاجِدًا. And then he goes into sujood, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَيُقَالَ لَهُ يا محمد ارفع رأسك. يا محمد ارفع رأسك وقل يسمع لك وسل تعطى واشفع تشفع. He صلى الله عليه وسلم will be told, يا محمد raise your head. The head that we put down. Allah, الذي لا إله. If the Prophet would see us, we'll put his head down. Out of sorrow. If he will see the conditions of this woman. And his Lord telling him, raise your head. We will put it down. And then we say, we love him. We follow him. Ya Muhammad, raise your head. And talk. We will listen. And ask, we will give you. And intercede, we will accept. So he asked Allah Azza wa Jal to start the hisab. He asked Allah to start the hisab. So Allah gives it. Gives it to him. وهذا المقام that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the position that only one person reached. This position, only one person. Only one person from the creation of Allah reaches. هذا المقام. هذا المقام المحمود. عسى أن يبعثك ربك مقاما محمودا. مقام محمود. For one of the creation of Allah. So he صلى الله عليه وسلم said, if you may finish the dua, make the dua. اللهم آت محمد وسيلة وفضيلة. درجة العالية رفع بعث المقام المحمود الذي وعد. طيب. فإذا علمنا بهذا, then we understand. Once we understand this, we understand that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is the best of the messengers. As a result, the best of all mankind. And there is no doubt that the messengers of Allah are different levels. The messengers of Allah, different levels. تِلْكَ الرُّسُلُ فَضَّلْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ. Some of the messengers of Allah, Allah spoke to. Some of the messengers of Allah, Allah took as Khalil, as He did with Ibrahim. He spoke as He did with Musa, alayhi salam. كَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا. كَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا. اتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. هذه منازل. تِلْكَ الرُّسُلُ فَضَّلْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ. إنهم من كلم الله وفضلهم درجة. أين عيسى بن مريم البينة؟ كل هذه أسباب تفضيل. All these are reasons for preference. So there is, as in the Quran, as in the Sunnah, there are states that the prophets reach different states and they are different preferences. And the best of all those are five ulil azm. The five ulil azm. Strongest of all the prophets, five. Five. يقول الله عز وجل وإذا خذنا من النبيين ميثاقهم ومنك ومن نوح وإبراهيم وموسى وعيسى. هذول الخمسة أولي العزم عيسى بن مريم. يقول الله شرع لكم من الدين ما وصى به نوحا والذي أوحينا إليك وما وصينا به إبراهيم وموسى وعيسى. هذه آيتين في الأحزاب والشورى. Two آيات in الأحزاب والشورى dictates or indicates as جمهور أهل العلم that those are أولي العزم. Those five. محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, إبراهيم عليه السلام, نوح, موسى, عيسى عليهم السلام. هذا تفضيل. This is obviously preference. And the best two of those five, Ibrahim and Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best of the two is Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. أنا سيد ولدي آدم ولا فخر. Now someone say, طب, it came that the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, it's reported that he said, do not differentiate between the messenger. Do not differentiate between the messengers. كما قال نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تفضلوا بين أنبياء الله. لا تفضلوا بين أنبياء الله. Do not differentiate between the prophets of Allah. And don't say one is better than هذا من باب. This comes if you're gonna praise someone over another with the intent to put the other down. Now when we praise Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, the whole since we started the lecture we're praising him صلى الله عليه وسلم, and we say خاتم الأنبياء, سيد الأتقياء, هذا إمام الأتقياء وسيد النبيين والمرسلين. There is no intention in our heart to say that the rest are worse than him or the rest are bad. No, they're all great messengers. But with their greatness, Muhammad is the greatest, صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then Ibrahim عليه السلام. Then Nuh, Musa, and Isa. But there is no intent and no claim that the rest of the prophets aren't that good. Or they're bad. No. They're all great. They're all the best of the people. But when it comes amongst them, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is the best of them. فالتفضيل and preference between the messengers of Allah is permissible as in the Quran, as in the Sunnah. But the point is, when he says, لو كان موسى حيا ما وسعه إلا اتباعي, طيب ما هذا تفضيل. He says, if Musa was alive, he would have no choice but to follow. مش هذا تفضيل. مش he says, saying in other words, I'm better than Musa, and my message is better than his message, and he has no choice but to follow me. Who follows who? The best follow. The best gets followed. So if tafdeel, if preference was with the intent of putting someone down, then that is when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbid. This hadith has a story, or this affair, this issue, that a Jew was selling some stuff, and he was given little money for it. Someone told him, I'll give you this for it. It was very little. So this Jew, as a Jew, he swore by Allah, but he said, وَالَّذِي اصْطَفَى مُوسَى عَلَى الْعَالَمِ. وَالَّذِي اصْطَفَى مُوسَى عَلَى الْبَشَرِ. He swore, a Jew. he wants to say that this prize is so long. So he swore by the one who chose Musa out of mankind. There was a Muslim slapped, smacked him in the face. Today they smack us in the face and in the back. He smacked him in the face. So this Jew or Jewish man went and complained to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Said, we had a dim, we had a man. We live under your supervision. We live under your protection. This is one of your men slapped. So when the Prophet ﷺ asked the Sahabi, why you did that? He said, he swore by the one who chose Musa over the creation, over mankind. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we know, he's the one. فَغَضِبَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمَ حَتَّى عُرِفَ الْغَضَبُ فِي وَجْهِهِ ثُمَّ قَالَ لَا تُفَضِّلُ بَيْنَ أَنْبِيَاءِ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهُ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ فَيُصْعَقُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ قَالَ ثُمَّ يُنْفَخُ فِيهِ أُخْرَى فَأَكُونُ أَوَّلَ مَنْ بُعِثَ فَإِذَا مُوسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ آخِذٌ بِالْعَرْشِ لَا أَدْرِي أَحُوسِبَ بِصَعْقَتِهِ يَوْمَ الطُّورِ أَوْ بُعِثَ قَبْلِ. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gets angry and he says, do not differentiate between the messengers of Allah. It will be blown in the horn in the day of judgment. فَيُصَعَقُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ فِي الزُّمُرِ or الزُّمُرِ, that everyone will die, will be shocked to the point of death. Everything in the heaven, everyone in the heavens, and everyone in the earth except what Allah wills. And then it will be blown again. And I will be the first one to be resurrected. Isa sallam talking about himself. I will be the first one to be resurrected. Then I look and I see Musa holding to the throne. So I don't know if he was not struck to start with as a compensation for the struck he received when he asked to see Allah. Remember? When Musa went to meet Allah for the 40 days and nights, قَالَ رَبِّ أَرِنِي أَنْظُرْ إِلَيْكَ. He asked Allah to see. طبعاً, he did not see Allah. But Allah told him, look to the mountain. If it stays where it is, then you will see. فَلَمَّا تَجَلَّ رَبُّهُ لِلْجَبَلِ خَرْ. So when Allah Azza wa Jal showed some of him to the mountain collapsed. As a result, when Musa saw that, Musa collapsed. So the Prophet said, I don't know. وَهَذَا دَلِيلٌ. And clear. هَذَا نَبِيُّ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. And he does not speak out of his own hawa. He said, I don't know. Was Musa saved from the blown or the struck because he was struck in the dunya already? Or he was resurrected before me? Or he was resurrected. He wants Rasulullah to show the level and the status of Musa alayhi salam. Yet we still know that he's not better than the Prophet Rasulullah. So when the differentiation comes with the intent of putting someone down over another, that's when it's forbidden. But when you come to praise someone because of his credentials, as the Prophet said, then that is permissible. فيعني سبب النهي والتعصب. تعصب and being fanatic. قال أبو جعفر رحمه الله وحبيب رب العالمين أي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني محبوب لله عز وجل ذات الله عز وجل loves him. كان الأولى على أبي جعفر أن يقول وخليل رب العالمين. فالأحباء كثر. الله عز وجل loves المتقين. Allah loves the mu'minin, Allah loves the muslimin, Allah loves the salimin, Allah loves the muhsinin. فَأَحِبَّا اللَّهُ كُثْرًا. أَمَّا الْخِلَّةِ فَهِيَ أَخَصُّ الْمَحَبِّ. الْخِلَّةِ is the highest state or the highest level of love. كان أولى أن يقول وَهُوَ خَلِيلُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَخَلِيلُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ أفضل من وَحَبِيبُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Because many share with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that. So for him, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, to be Habibullah, Many people do. But to be خليل الله, هذه خاصة, special. Okay? يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم علي, لأعطين الراية غدا رجلا يحب الله ورسوله ويحبه الله ورسوله. هذا حبيب. والخلة one of the special things that he shares with Ibrahim عليه السلام. فنحن لا نعلم أخلاء لله إلا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وإبراهيم عليه السلام. Okay. وهذا مصداق قوله تعالى عن إبراهيم واتخذ الله إبراهيم خليلا. أما في النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فهو الحديث يقول ألا إني أبرأ إلى كل خل من خله ولو كنت متخذا خليلا لاتخذت أبا بكر خليلا إن صاحبكم خليل الله. He صلى الله عليه وسلم. He says I denounce every خليل from his خليل. طيب. We read that أبو هريرة يعني من حديث أبو هريرة narrates he said أخبرني خليلي عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. أخبرني خليلي. إذهاب المحمل أو match the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said أنا أبرأ من كل خليل من خليل إلى كل خليل من خليل. هو أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه speak about it as the feelings he feels. He wants to express what he feels. But في النهاية هو ما النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خليله الله. ما في أحد من الخلق أخلى للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. هو ما اتخذ أي خليل إلا الله. فالخلة هي صفاء القلب للمحبوب. أنت بتحب واحد, you love someone, but you could love many others, and at the same time, this someone you love, you could hate some things about. Still حب. And then you love your children, but not everything about them. You love your wife, but not anything, I mean, not everything about her. ماشي؟ Not everything. أما لما تصل درجة الخلاء, القانون بيصير إيه؟ If you are خليل to someone, you have no choice but to love every single thing about them. Even things that hurt you. Even things that hurt you. كيف يعني؟ يقول الله تعالى كتب عليكم القتال وهو كره لكم. He says صلى الله عليه وسلم, or he says سبحانه وتعالى, fighting is prescribed unto you even though you hate it. So naturally you hate it. But because it's from Allah, you're gonna do it. And the love that Allah requires. So even though it's against your nature, no one wants to go kick, or someone go get killed. No one wants to go and leave his family and get killed or lose his family. أما أنت, you do it for Allah. فالخلة is a state where the love takes over completely, or completely takes over the heart. So you can only love what the one you love or your khalil loves. شوف. You only love what your khalil loves. Then he will be your khalil. أما other than that, no. يعني الصحابة, أنس رضي الله عنه, he said, I'm sitting eating with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he's صلى الله عليه وسلم in the soup searching for الدباء. الدباء يعني piece of pumpkin, قرب. قالوا أنا يعني wherever I find it, I put it in his way. فما زلت أحب الدباء. Since then I love الدباء. هو he did, naturally he didn't love it. But when he saw the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم loves it, and those people gave the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم their hearts, when he saw that his khalil loves it, خلاص, he has no choice. the law of khilla dictates that he loves it, even if he doesn't enjoy it. Abu Ayyub al-Ansari, the Prophet stays in his house when he makes hijrah. He serves him food, the food comes back untouched. What happened, Ya Rasulullah? It has garlic or onion. وَإِنِّ يُنَاجِي مَنْ لَا تُنَاجِي. And he speaks to the Malaika, صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Malaika hate this man. So Abu Ayyub said, and I don't love garlic anymore. خلص. خلة. Love, love, love. هذا الحب. هذا الحب. This is the true love. Other than that, it's a feeling, comes and goes. Feeling that comes and goes. So one of the special characters of the Prophet ﷺ is that he is Khalil al-Rahman. He is Khalil al-Rahman, and the only other one is Ibrahim alayhi salam. He ﷺ says, I denounce every Khalil from his Khalil. And then he said, if I was to take anyone as Khalil from the people, I would take Abu Bakr. خلاص. يعني this hadith completely clearly declares it, makes it clear. Abu Bakr is the Khalifa. Don't come and say no, someone else. No. خلاص. يعني if the Prophet ﷺ was alive and they asked him, who's the Khalifa after him? Which they did. You think he's going to say other than Abu Bakr? He did. Yeah, he did. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a woman comes to him to ask. So he tells her, come. She said, what if I don't find you? He said, ask Abu Bakr. Then أما الذين في قلوبهم مرض فيتبعون ما تشابه منه ابتغاء الفتنة. واضح. He صلى الله عليه وسلم cannot go out to pray when he's dying. مروا أبا بكر فليصلي في الناس. Order أبو بكر let him lead the people in the ما أهل الهوى وأهل الزيغ والضلال. They can start playing with that. It's very clear. Very clear. Someone who's just in looking at the Adilla, very clear. And to bring a kafir or someone who has nothing to do with Islam, show him the adillah about praising this sahabi and this sahabi and this sahabi and Abu Bakr and Umar and Ali, and tell him which one you think that these proofs dictates that should be the khalifa of the Prophet. I have no doubt it will be Umar. So he said, if I was to take Khalil from amongst people, I will take Abu Bakr. But I am Khalil Allah. Khalil Allah. He is the Khalil of Allah. The love of Allah took over his heart. There is no place to put someone else. No place. And the other hadith, إن الله اتخذني خليلا كما اتخذ إبراهيم خليلا. Allah took me as Khalil the way he took Ibrahim Khalil. وهذا دليل في إثبات صفة المحبة لله. That this is a clear دليل that Allah loves. Not as أهل البدع. Who said Allah doesn't love? So when you come across the إن الله يحب المحسنين. He says يحب. Allah says فاتبعوني يحببكم الله. Of course, they started making ta'wil and tahrif in nusus. They started interpreting and changing the meaning of these words. Yuhib yahdiya. Change. Yuhib يعني he will give them tawfiq to do the right. Kullu kalam. Ma anzal Allah bihi min sultan. Yuhib. Allah loves. And Allah is loved. The believers love Allah, and Allah loves the believers. The believer's love to him, the love that's going up is different than the love that's coming down. Simple. And we're out of the whole mess. في حديث لا يصح سندا ولا مثنى. That many groups, thieving groups repeat, إن إبراهيم, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إن إبراهيم خليل الله وأنا حبيب الله ولا فخر. That Ibrahim is the خليل of Allah, and I am the love of Allah and no pride. طبعا to be حبيب الله doesn't carry any special thing. طبعا it's special in general. But for the Prophet, يعني, to be specially for one person, it's not, because many. And Allah didn't love Musa, didn't love Isa. So many أحباء الله, as we said already. أما الخليل فهذا special. خليل special. Again, this hadith is, يعني لا سند ولا متن. Cannot have good chain for it. And even the متن, oppose the متن itself, the context. Opposes authentic hadith. So the whole thing is not valid. Alright? فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خليل. خليل الله. That's why it was better for Abu Ja'far رحمه الله to say, وخليل رب العالمين. كل قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد الحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.